Sure. So next service is healthcare service. Healthcare is also important because it comes in exam as a dedicated hospital case will come. Okay. Your SSC will be some hospital. So please understand what all healthcare services are exempt we have. So the first exemption is given for veterinary clinic in relation to healthcare of animals and birds. It's not only human hospitals which are exempt, even animal and birds hospital are exempt. Not much. Okay. Next, we are having services by way of healthcare, services provided by clinical establishment. When I say clinical establishment, it's big size hospitals. All right. So they are clinical establishment. An authorized medical practitioner. So some small clinics are there. Yes or no? All right. Doctor individually, he will have his own clinic. That is authorized medical practitioners. And third is paramedics. Paramedics means nurses, doctors, people who take your, X-ray. They are not doctors. They are paramedics. All right. So even their services are exempt. Only these three people are exempt. If your mother is giving you services, healthcare, who is not medical practitioner, with some Ayurveda knowledge, she is giving you something, that is not exempt here. Yes or no? All right. Only services provided by clinical establishment, authorized medical practitioner, and paramedics. Only these three people are exempt who are providing you healthcare services. Sir, apart from that, services provided by way of transportation of patient. Transportation of disease was covered in Schedule 3, negative list. Yes. Alright. So that was already not taxable. Patient was taxable because if you are alive, then it would have become taxable. But as per this entry, one patient is not taxable. So patient is also exempt and dead body is also exempt. Not exempt, it is not taxable because it is covered under Schedule 3. Yes. Am I clear? Yeah. Then services provided by blood bank or by preservation of sperm cell, that connecting point of baby and mother, that cord that they nowadays they are reserving it, and yesterday one student was telling us almost 70 to 80,000 is a fees for preserving that sperm cell, and which is exempt in law right now. Okay, it's not taxable. Now when I say healthcare, okay, what exactly is the healthcare? The definition is also important. Healthcare does not include hair transplantation and plastic and cosmetic surgery. If your nose is not straight and you are doing it straight, okay, or if your hair are fallen and then you are putting hairs in that, so it's not healthcare service, and therefore this service is provided by even though authorized medical practitioners would be taxable, but then exception have exception. All right. So this is not tax, this is not exempt, this is taxable. So cosmetic surgery, plastic surgery is taxable. But you are doing healthcare, this plastic surgery or cosmetic surgery or hair plantation because you met with an accident or it was the outcome of birth disease. So by birth only, okay, that baby was having some problem. And to cure that problem, if they are doing some surgery, then it is covered, okay. So look at this, does not include hair transplant, cosmetic and plastic surgery, except when the undertaken to restore or reconstruct anatomy or functions of a body affected due to congenital defects, that means by birth defect, or development of abnormalities, injury or trauma. So if it is because of these activities, then only it is taxable. If you are doing it for beautification, then it is not exempt, it will become taxable. Am I clear? Yeah. So this is the one thing that you need to understand. Now, what are the authorized medical systems of India? So it's not only allopathy is exempt. Allopathy means the injection and medicine that we take, tablets and capsules. That is allopathy. It's not only allopathy which is exempt. Apart from allopathy, even yoga is also covered as a healthcare. Alright. So yoga is there, naturopathy. Naturopathy means, for some diseases there is no medicine. You have to spend time in that nature. Alright. There was one Govinda's movie, okay. Jis Desh Mein Ganga Rehta Hai, kind of very old movie, where he had developed certain diseases, so he must stay with goats. Yes. Alright, so his family, they keep him in some village. Yes. Yes or no? So that is naturopathy. Ayurveda, you already know, okay. Homeopathy is Siddha, Yunani, some, you know, that Panchakarma and all they do. Alright, so all these activities are exempt in law. Next. So this is healthcare. Where is it? Okay. In hospital, sometimes they supply food. Yes or no? because patient is not allowed to eat outside. When treatment is going on, you need to eat food from hospital itself, which is completely tasteless, oil-less, salt-less food. Yes or no? Alright. But that's the requirement of the time. It's not that you are in a restaurant and you will order anything. Okay, aaj menu mein kya hai? No. Alright. So, you need to eat food provided by hospital. Okay, depending upon your dietitian, that those people are there who will give you food. Now you were hungry, therefore you got admitted in the hospital, or you got admitted and then they are providing you food. So what is the dominant supply? Healthcare. Yes or no? Because restaurant per se, only restaurant is taxable. Now hospital is giving you two services. Healthcare and catering services or food services, restaurant services. So should it be taxable because it is a composite supply? Are you getting this? Two supply made for a single price. Hello? So you tell me, is it a composite supply or mixed supply? Naturally it is happening, okay, and the predominant service is healthcare, because healthcare itself is exempt. That food bill also will be exempt, okay. So that is just the additional point I told you. Services provided by government. Now services provided by government is very important when you go to CMA final or professional exam, final level exam. Here we are not going into in depth of it, but still we have to discuss certain points which are core of this particular exemption. First of all, why the hell government is putting tax on themselves? Okay, you know that person of, in definition of person, government is included, and there only I told you even government is taxable. When I say government is taxable, it's like taking money from your one pocket and putting in another pocket. If Ministry of Railway paying tax to Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Railway is also government, Ministry of Finance is also government. So technically there is no payment of tax, but still they are charging tax. So why, sir? Because it is the commercial parlance, okay, to provide equal field to private sector companies. Now for that you need to understand this, okay. Some basic first two activities are very basic activities which are exempt, like cleaning and all is the responsibility of government. This keeping this road clean is the responsibility of government. But government have this given this contract to Ramki Infrastructure. You know, people in India, there are two people in India who cleans Mumbai. Not India, Mumbai. In Mumbai, we are having two people who clean Mumbai. One people who are in, you know, brown color clothes, you know, khaki. All right, they are municipality people, they are local government people. Apart from that, we are having green color, and on the shirt it is written clean up. All right, that green color people are not government people, they are private sector company. But what activity they are doing? They are cleaning the city. Alright, so don't you think they are charging some money from government for doing so?
Yes.
Yes? So that money is exempt because they are doing some constitutional function which was entrusted to government bodies. And government bodies not capable enough to handle the whole Mumbai, so they have given the contract to private sector body. Hello? Yes. Alright, so here please understand, services provided by government. So here the services by government. Here by and to matters a lot. By government. Authority, government or government authority by way of any activity in relation to any function interested to municipality. So government providing all those services which are interested to municipality, so that those activities should be done by municipality. All activities which can be done by municipality, which is written in Constitution Article 243W. So there is a list of activities in your model, they have given the list of activities which is given under 243W. Whatever your municipality does through Constitution of India is exempt. Okay. Similarly, in cities we are having municipality, in villages we are having gram panchayat. So for them article is 243G. Only article will change, otherwise activities remains almost same. Okay. So municipality activities are also exempt and panchayat activities are also exempt. Okay. So we were not talking about 4 and 5, we have to talk much about entry number 6. Entry number 6 is the main entry of government services. It exempts all services provided by government. Hello? It exempts what? All services provided by government. Now when I say government, which government, sir? Central government, state government, union territory and local authorities. Okay? So all these bodies are exempt. All services provided by them is exempt. Then, sir, then what is taxable? Excluding following services. The moment I say something is excluded from exemption, something is excluded from exemption, that means taxable. So this point number A, B, C, D, there are 4 points. Are taxable or not taxable?
Taxable.
Taxable. This much you understood. Very good. So the first point, first point is, this is taxable point, okay? Because it is excluded from exemption. Now, when is it taxable and what is taxable? So, services by Department of Post. Department of Post is a government department? Yes or no? So, services of Department of Post by way of only four activities. Only four. Whenever in law they put this word by way of means they have to provide some list to next to it now. Hello? Some list is there. Only four activities they are going to talk now. Okay. By way of, first activity is speed post. You need to remember this. Speed post. Second is express parcel post. Third is life insurance. And fourth is? These four activities are taxable. Am I clear? So speed post, express parcel, life insurance and agency service provided to a person. Please understand. Provided to a person other than central government, state government and Indian territory. That means these four services they are providing to two different person. One is to any person and second is central government, state government, Union territory. Are you getting this? If it is provided to any person, then it is taxable. If it is provided by government to government, bhai bhai ka nata. Okay, bro to bro. Alright, central government, like Department of Post is delivering letter of income tax department. Hello? Department of Post is delivering letter of income tax department by using speed post. Taxable or not taxable? So, not taxable. Why? Because it is provided by government to government. Whenever it is provided by government to government, it is exempt. It is exempt. That means if it is provided by government to me and you, normal people, then it is taxable. Are you getting this? Sir, but Department of Post is going to pay tax to Department of Revenue. Isn't like this? I am saying Department of Post is taxable. Four activities of Department of Post is taxable. It's like government paying tax to government. Yes or no? Alright. So why is it done? Because in India, we are having private courier companies also. Yes. Professional courier, Maruti courier, then DTDC is there, Blue Dart is there. Yes or no? Alright. So many private companies are there. Now, this is a private company and this is the government post, Department of Post. Okay? I'm showing you. For one speed post here, you have to pay 1000 rupees. Because this is private sector, it is chargeable under GST. So, we have to add 18%. So, 180. So, 1180 they will charge. Yes or no? Because this is Department of Post, they will only charge 1000. Imagine they are not charging GST. So where you will go to put your courier? Government, Department of Post or private? Obviously you will go to government. And if this happens, but government services are not that good. You must have experienced Department of Post services are not that good. You compare with private courier company and Department of Post, you will always like to go to private. But here you are going to government because you can save money. Sir, okay, only for 180 I will not go to Department of Post, I will go to private sector. You are exceptional one. Hello? You are exceptional one. If I have to deliver 1000 letters then? 180 multiplied by 1000 letter is very big thing. No, I'm a company. Okay, I have to call for an annual general meeting. I have 10 lakh shareholders. That means 10 lakh into 180 is very good number. No, hello, all right. Therefore, I will never try to go to private sector. I will always go to. Then gradually, what will happen? Our private sector company, they will die. Yes or no? Then employment will go down. Is it an intention of government of India that GST should kill businesses? No, GST should not kill business. In fact, GST should encourage businesses. Yes or no? Alright. So what has happened? I have two choices now. Why people are going to Department of Post and not here? Because although price is same, both are charging 1000 rupees, but here there is a GST and here there is no GST. So I have two choices. What are the choices I have? If I have to give private sector versus government sector, both equal field. Now you fight for your quality. Hello? Price wise, both will be same. GST should not play any role into your pricing. Yes or no? So I have two options. First option, I should exempt private sector also. Yes or no? Yes. Then this will become same. Either I can exempt private sector, but exempting private sector means, hello, loss of revenue. Yes or no? Exempting private sector means loss of? They wanted to tax private sector. They wanted to tax private sector. But if they tax private sector, prices are not same. So what government will do? What is the second option? Government should also put tax on themselves. Now what will happen? Prices are same. Now prices are same. Now where will you go? Where will you go? Now you will go to private because they are providing services better, faster, and sometimes even cheaper. Hello? Are you getting this? So GST should not kill private business, therefore certain activities provided even by government are taxable. But then there are activities which are exclusively provided by government, not provided by private sector. Like that inland letter, you know that brown color card, inland letter or green color letter was there, okay, which can be delivered by, you know, just charging 1 or 2 rupees, not more than that. Hello? You just buy that letter and it will be delivered. There is no guarantee that it will be delivered, but majority cases people used to expect that it will be delivered. That is not speed post, that is normal post, ordinary post. So Department of Post, ordinary post is not taxable, it is exempt. Why? Because we don't have any competition from private sector. Speed post we have private sector. Life insurance, tell me, do we have private sector in life insurance? Yes. So therefore life insurance even by provided by Department of Post is taxable. Agency services, bank can act as the agents of various company, likewise Department of Post also can act as a agent to various company, collection of bill and all. Hello? Alright. So both are acting. So private sector, public sector, both are involved. So both are paying taxes. Are you getting this? To provide equal field. But it's not that all services provided by post is taxable. Only 4 services are taxable. Which are 4? Speed post, express parcel post, life insurance and agency service. And that too if it is provided to government by government. Okay. To government by government then exempt. Am I clear? So this is the first activity. Second activity that we need to talk here is, okay, services in relation to aircraft and vessel. If my aircraft or vessel, if this is India and this is the vessel which is not working properly, okay, so I may not be able to bring this vessel here for repairing. So from here one team should go there and do the repair work. Are you getting this? Okay, now when I call nearest coastal port, either government people may come or private sector may come. Hello? Whichever is available, government sector or? Somebody, both type of player are there. Private players are also there in this business and government players are also there in this business. Am I clear? Alright. So what they are saying, services in relation to aircraft or vessel inside or outside the premises. Inside means inside the area which is reserved for vessel and aircraft or outside. So exemption is given inside also, exemption is not given inside also, exemption is not given outside also. Why is it taxable? Because there are 2 players into this business. Government bodies are also there and private bodies are also there. Yes or no? Again that price mismatch will happen and therefore any services provided in relation to vessel and aircraft. Now when I say any in relation to, they have not mentioned exactly which activities. See, when they use by way of, they need to mention which activity. So these 2 languages are opposite to each other in law. By way of means they have to give the list of activities because only those activities are taxable or only those activities are exempt. Okay. In relation to me, any services in relation to aircraft and vessel is exempt. Any service. Any means what, sir? It can be parking services. It can be repair services. It can be cleaning services. Hello, it can be catering services. Any services in relation to vessel and aircraft provided by government is exempt. Is not exempt because it is excluded from exemption. Excluded from exemption means taxable. And why taxable? Because private sector is also providing relation to vessel and aircraft. Am I clear? So till now 2 points you have kept in mind which are taxable. Okay, which 2 points? First of all, services of Department of Post. By way of, come on, tell me 4 services. Speed post, express parcel, life insurance and agency service provided to a person other than central government, state government and union territory. So this is the first point. Second, services in relation to vessel and aircraft is also taxable. Oh, inside and outside principle doesn't make any difference. Services in relation to vessel and aircraft is taxable. So first taxable, second taxable. Third, we should not be speaking much about the third. But according to this entry, it is taxable. What, sir? Transportation of goods and transportation of passenger. So government is also providing a lot of transportation of goods and transportation of passenger services. At the same time, private sector is also involved into transportation of goods and transportation of passenger. I should not be speaking much here because according to this entry, it fills whole government transportation system is taxable, but in reality you must have observed railway, bus, okay, so many activities are actually exempt, yes or no? Because we are having separate entry for transportation of goods and transportation of passenger. That we will discuss in that entry. Am I clear? But right now, even transportation of goods and passenger, even provided by government, is exempt. Is not exempt. Excluded from exemption. It is taxable. Am I clear? So till now, three activity provided by government. By default, all activities of government is exempt. All we are learning exemptions. So all activities of government is exempt. Till now, three activities you have remembered which are taxable. The first activity was Department of Post by way of speed post, express parcel, life insurance, agent service provided to a person other than central government, state government and union territory. Second, service in relation to vessel and aircraft. Third, transportation of goods and transportation of. These three activities are excluded from exemption and therefore it is taxable. Am I clear? Now, the moment you read last entry, your brain will blow off. Okay? What are we trying to understand? We are trying to understand all services provided by government is exempt, excluding four. 1, 2, 3 are specific nature, so we understand, okay, 1, 2, 3 is taxable. Okay? Look at the fourth one. Any service provided by government is taxable. Hello? Look at the fourth language. This word is disaster. Any service provided by government is taxable. Any service provided by government is taxable. What are we learning? All services provided by government is exempt. This is law. Exception to law. 1, 2, 3, 4 or A, B, C, D. Only these four activities are taxable. A was the Department of Post, four activities. B was service in relation to aircraft and vessel. And third was transportation of goods and transportation of passengers. So we thought only these three are taxable. Fourth one is any service provided by government is taxable. So government is exempt or taxable? Because government say all services are exempt. All are exempt. Yes or no? Hello. All exempt except A, except B, except C and except D. A, B, C is okay. But what is the B, D? Any service provided by government is taxable. Because of last one, what is happening? My whole exemption notification is getting nullified. Yes. Technically, nothing is exempt. Technically, everything is taxable. Are you getting this? Why? From exemption notification, four items are excluded. Which four items? Department of Post, four activities, aircraft and vessel, transportation of goods and passenger, and any other service provided by government. What does that mean? Everything is removed from exemption. That means everything becomes taxable. Hello, everything becomes taxable because everything is removed from exemption. But then the language is not half, okay? Please try to understand any service other than ABC, because ABC above we have already discussed, okay? Any other service other than ABC provided only to, so if this last point is not for general public, if government provides service to general public, it is still exempt. Hello, any service provided to business entity means commercial entity, proprietorship firm, partnership firm, company, LLP, business entities, for them, okay, any services provided to business entity is taxable. Am I clear? So scope of ABC is very limited. Scope of taxability of ABC is very limited, very precise. But scope of D is so wide. Why? Because they have not mentioned which service is taxable. Which service is taxable? Any service provided to business entity is taxable. Am I clear? So which four activities are taxable? Which are, see, by default all services of government is exempt. Except four. Four are taxable. Which are four? First, Department of Post by way of speed post, express parcel, life insurance, agency service provided to a person other than central government, state government and union territory. Second one is services provided to in relation to aircraft and vessel. Third is transportation of goods, transportation of passengers. And fourth, the taxability is very big taxability. any service provided to business entity is taxable. And I, let me remind you, any service provided to business entity is taxable on reverse charge basis. Hello? Any service provided to business entity is taxable, and that too taxable on reverse charge basis. Reverse charge mechanism is written in notification number 13. Already we have written that. Am I clear? Now, because the last entry is taxing so many items, okay, it created, you know, panic in the industry. It created panic in the industry because so many services business entity takes from government side. Am I clear? Alright. So, to nullify effect of this D, see, D is only disaster. Okay. To nullify effect of D, government have inserted almost more than 10 to 12 new entries just to, you know, dilute effect of D. You understand? D is the strongest taxable point. Are you getting? It's taxing everything which is provided to business entity by government. Are you getting this? Everything given by government to business entity is taxable. But then we have to reduce the effect of taxability, because we don't want government services to become costlier in the industry. If you tax government, then what will happen? If you tax all government activity, then what will happen? Cost of taking services from government will go high. Yes or no? Alright. And therefore, we were afraid. So, government to nullify effect of D has introduced so many new entries. Look at this entry. So, by looking at D entry, we feel that all business entity is taxable. Yes or no?
Yes.
Services provided by government to all business entity is taxable. Entry number 7 says, but if this entity is a small entity, then it is not taxable. Hello? And how do they define small entity? That entity's turnover is less than 20 lakh. So if small entity takes services from government, then not taxable. If big entity takes service from government, then it is taxable. But not as per entry number 6, entry number 7. And therefore you need to remember all entries to understand the law. Hello? As per entry number 6, all business entities are taxable.
Yes.
As per entry number 7, small business entities are exempt. Hello? And how do I say which entity is small entity or big entity? Yeah. If that entity turnover is less than 20 lakh and government is providing some services to them, they are not supposed to pay tax.
Yes,
yes or no? Because they are small entity, because tax is on reverse charge basis. Unnecessary, you are putting burden on that small business entity. Hello? Alright. So if my turnover is 14 lakh and I took services from government, taxable or not taxable?
Not taxable.
Because I am a small entity, I cannot follow your reverse charge mechanism and all. Hello? Are you getting this? But 20 lakh for normal states, 10 lakh for
special
states. Yes or no? That Mizoram, Manipur, Meghalaya, Nagaland, Tripura, Sikkim. So for this state we are having 10 lakh. Am I clear? Can I go ahead? Yeah, next. Services provided by central government, state government, union territory, local or local to another central government, state government. So bye.
Yes.
Hello? Because even central government, state government is also a business entity. They also do business. Yes or no? So point number D says services provided by government to any business entity, and that business entity can also be a government. Hello? So services provided by government to government was also taxable as per point number D. Hello? So to nullify that effect, what they have seen? They're saying services provided by government to government is not taxable, even though that government is a business entity, still it is not taxable. Am I clear? Yeah. Next, services provided by government where consideration does not exceed 5000. This is MCQ, where consideration does not exceed 5000. So I am taking some services from government and I am a big business entity. 50 lakh rupees is my turnover. Yes or no? I am taking some services from government and government is charging 600 rupees for that. Only for 600 rupees do you want to activate reverse charge mechanism and compliance burden? Hello? No. So what government is saying, if the consideration of the value of services is very low means how much? Less than? Then also it is not taxable, it is exempt. It is exempt. Are you getting? All these entries have come to nullify or the, you know, reduce the impact of entry number D. Because entry number D say any service is taxable. Then other entities are trying to, you know, dilute the impact. You understand dilution? You cannot, some people cannot drink whiskey directly. So what they do? They add water or soda into it. Yes or no? to dilute the impact. Are you getting this? Entry number D is very strong. All other entries are trying to dilute the impact of taxability. Hello?
Yes.
They are trying to reduce the impact of taxability. Are you getting this? Pakka, sure?
Yes.